This week, we covered a lot of ground. After dropping the boys off in Nassau for the flight home, we needed to hightail it to Florida to go get our lithium batteries and our helm enclosure. We had an easy 20-hour overnight passage to Bimini, then a Gulf crossing to Fort Lauderdale. Nailed the docking in Harbor Town, got the batteries, and took a quick diversion on a local adventure. Then we hopped on a flight back to Texas for a trip to visit family and friends. It was quite a week. 'Cause even in the madness, there's peace, drowning out the voices all around me. Through all of this chaos, you are writing a symphony. We were anchored in New Providence, and we needed to sail 170 miles to get back to Fort Lauderdale, so we decided to split it up into 2 days.
They're both asleep right now, so... It's been pretty fun, though. I am... having a good time. We just dropped our cousins off at the airport at around 10, so not really just dropped off, so 5 hours ago-ish. And I have nobody to talk to, so I'm just gonna talk to a camera for about 30 more minutes. And we got this giant flag from our friends Chasing 28, so thank you to them.
William had a lot to say, and in the interest of time, I cut most of it. I'm sorry, dude. The passage was pretty uneventful. We did 2-hour shifts since we only had one night to deal with, and this time we threw William into the mix. The weather was super calm, not a wave to be seen anywhere. Once the sun came up, the weather changed and we got a little rocky on our way into Bimini, but all in, it was a good overnight. The next morning, we got off the dock early and headed off across the Gulf Stream to Fort Lauderdale. Weather models showed it was going to be calm, but reality showed it was going to be a little different. It was bigger than expected, but manageable. We had some dolphins visit us for a while, a really nice distraction from the bumpy ride. And then, before we knew it, we were in Fort Lauderdale. It was a fairly smooth trip. We docked and started diving into boat tasks. Now, wherever you are, you should knock off for an adventure every now and again. Some friends were going over to a park near the marina, and we tagged along. It's a barrier island between the ocean and the intercoastal, and there's a small mangrove river on the western side of it. It's perfect for a long dinghy ride.
So Amy T asked how we are liking the upgrades we have made to the boat and whether there was anything we would change. Can you think of anything?
Well, I mean, the upgrades that we did, we put like a door, kind of made a pantry more accessible than under a seat, and that is fabulous. Trying to think of other things. The shower outside is neat and all. We use it off and on, but I think it's really nice to have there.
It does use a lot more water.
Yeah, because it's constant.
You don't have a handle right there to turn it off and on while you're showering.
But it's very convenient.
Yeah.
And I think it's nice because it stops you and you're like, all right, shower off, get all the salt water off and rinse out your suit or whatever. Big upgrade we're very excited about that we'll have when we get back to Florida is the helm enclosure. I think we're going to be most excited about that. And I believe we told the folks at Leopard that they just need to tell everybody get a helm enclosure because with the wind, we haven't had such a problem with rain because we've really been trying to watch the weather and sail that way, not in the rain, but it's just the wind, it's very biting and chapping and it wears you down. So
yeah, even in light winds, if you're up there for 6 hours, it's going to wear you out, even if there's no wind. And so, yeah, getting the enclosure on there is going
to
be.
And he has facial hair to help with that stuff. I don't. So I'm like, moisturize, because I don't want to get all leathery old skin. So I'm trying to do things to help, you know.
Can you think of any upgrades that were like, could have done without that?
I can't think anything specific right now because I can't think of what the upgrades are.
The water maker is just glorious. Badass. It's so good, so easy to use. If you take care of it, it'll last a really long time. Solar panels are awesome. They're going to be great now that we have lithium batteries that can make full use of them. Washing machine. What do you think of the washing machine?
Yeah, I think it's really nice to have. I'm still trying to figure out the usage, the timing of it all, how much to put in and all of that. I'm very, very thankful for that because even if you just need to run a quick load of your undies and things like that, shorts that dry fast, I'm very thankful that we have that. Though I have used a bucket and Castile soap and that works really good too. So we did our mattress topper. And I'm really happy with that. I know a lot of people have purchased a custom mattress for about $5,000. And our mattress topper, I think, that came in under $1,000. And I'm very happy with that because the firmness of the mattress that was standard with the boat with that topper, I think, has just been perfect. So,
yeah. $5,000 mattresses were comfortable. I got to go sit on one and
people
it was
like
very,
them.
Very nice. But this will do. Underwater lights.
Underwater lights are way cool. I look forward to having more lights if that's something in the future. We really enjoyed watching the fish and everything, and there was one fish at an anchorage that seemed to just totally dig the light, and it was really fun watching him and watching all the shadows and everything. So yeah, underwater lights, big time. I know one upgrade we did get. What we got up at the, what do you call the little sitting area up top?
Oh, the lounge?
The lounge. We got these lights that come up out of the boat. They were a little pricey. I like them. I think it's good to have. I mean, we could carry up a light, I suppose, but so I don't know. That might be something where I might say, yeah, maybe you don't have to do that, but we never didn't have it. So it's kind of, I do like having it. They're very functional and easy to put away, and that's good. You're not going to trip over them or forget them and that kind of stuff.
Yeah. I think that was all the upgrades. Okay. So another, this is kind of a combination of different questions. We had a lot of questions about our batteries and a lot of input and ideas around them. An update on that, we got back to Florida and the next day they put the lithium batteries into the boat. And when they pulled the AGM batteries out, they were all swollen. Now, that happens, from what I understand, that happens when you've overcharged a battery. And we have a Victron charger inverter system. It's top of the line, awesome stuff. And it could have been that. That could have been not programmed correctly. It could have been something that happened in the factory. It could have been something that happened anywhere between South Africa and here. So there's no telling why they were in that condition, but they were in that condition. And that would explain why we were only able to get about 4 hours of use from full charge to 11.7 volts. And my main concern was one of the reasons we got the AGM upgrade through Leopard was because that also upgrades the starter batteries for both engines and the generator. And so I was worried that, oh gosh, if those were swollen, are these other batteries going to be swollen? They are not connected through the charger inverter. They're connected to the alternators on their respective engines. So I don't think if it was a charger inverter problem or overcharging from that, then I don't think that we'd see that on these. When we get back to the boat, I'm going to go in and inspect those batteries just to make sure they're not swollen, but I'm pretty confident they probably are going to be fine. So that was the problem with the batteries. It shouldn't be a problem now. When we get back, we're going to unplug from shore power and run on the lithium batteries for a couple days just to make sure that everything works the way that we think it should work. And then we should be good to go, and we'll keep an eye on it as we keep going. So one other question I got was actually from Tom, our Leopard guy. We got back and he asked how it went, and I said it was way beyond our expectations. And he said, well, why do you think that is? And I didn't have a good answer for him. And the next morning I sent him an email, and I said, you know, I have to steal the lyric of a song from Lord Huron. And the lyric is, what good is living a life you've been given if all you're doing is standing in place? And so I think part of what we've enjoyed so far is, you know, that getting out of the comfort zone, but getting out of routine, mm-hmm. getting out of going to the same Mexican restaurant every Friday night, and getting out of doing the same vacation every year is really pushed us, right? Like it's different. It's more interesting. It's more exciting. So if there's one takeaway from it, it's that, right? Get out there and go do things, go do different things. Don't get in a rut. And that doesn't mean go buy a sailboat and go sail across the world. That means if you've driven past a park 100 times and you haven't gone and walked around in it, stop and go walk around, you know, go do something different from what you normally do.
Yeah. You know, we're not getting any younger. Our brains are not, you know, they're getting old. And I think doing this new thing is really good learning. And honestly, the problems and issues that we've had with batteries and things, we appreciate it, because problem solving, just doing things, you're not stagnant sitting there, because we're not vacationing. You know, we're doing fun things that you do on vacation, but this is not vacationing. I think we've learned so much about ourselves and our marriage and our time with our son that I think he really needed, just to have us and him, though we do all need breaks from each other in that regard.
Somebody's going to comment about that.
But he it's just been really good for so many reasons. And like Todd said, I don't think you have to go buy a sailboat and do this, but definitely do things that put you out of your comfort zone, and new things, like learning something new, like learning the sailing stuff. I was really nervous at the first ASA class, but it was just so good to learn something new. I just think that we need to do that, yeah, and get out of the rut and honestly slow down. Has been really, really nice. Nobody needs to go that fast that us as Americans, I think, are going. You know, we're connected 24 hours a day now. I think that's not great sometimes. So the fact that our cell coverage doesn't always work is good. And I need to lean to some of the other activities that I brought on the boat besides my phone and reading a book on my phone or reading my Bible on my phone or playing a game on my phone. I need to bring the sewing thing that I brought. I brought scrapbooking stuff for my kids that I figured I could, you know, tackle while we're out there. So.
Yeah, I brought guitars. I'm really kind of excited to start working on writing some music. So my goal is to write some music that I can actually put into our videos. It might be crappy, but it'll be
you're
something.
Trying.
Yeah, it'll be something new, and I'll create it. And
yeah.
So that's the big idea, right? That just get out there, do something different, and
push yourself. I mean, we did a 20-hour overnight passage, and doing all the little things that we did, it was like, okay, we've got to go 9 hours after this 20-hour passage, no problem. What, it's really, really choppy and uncomfortable, no problem. Like, yeah. we can tackle this, we can do it. And then we had the sweet, you know, thing of seeing the little dolphin pod swim around our boat for a while.
Yeah.
That was just really neat and serene, and that was cool.
Yeah. All right, anyway, that was our last question. So that's about it. We're in Texas, as you can see. We're at our house in Blanco and just trying to get it cleaned up and ready for vacation rental. We're going to put the house on vacation rental. Hopefully that'll provide us some income to offset the loss of income that we're going to go through taking a break from work. We'll see how that math all works out. We're going back to Florida in a couple days. We'll get prepped and ready for a much longer journey, and then we'll set out back into the Bahamas with the goal of getting to Georgetown around Christmas, and then we'll have a roving cast of children coming and going on the boat for a couple of weeks, and it should be a lot of fun. We'll be traveling with a couple other boats. And so until next week, thanks for watching, and we'll see you then. Boop.